Hello. Well, today I want to do something different. I want to talk to you about the effect of caffeine on your cardiovascular health as well as your mental health. More specifically, I want to talk to you about the effect of caffeine on your blood pressure as well as anxiety. So I'm going to do something different. What I want to do is I'm going to go into that coffee shop over there and I'm going to buy some coffee just to illustrate the point. Okay, so let's go in. Yeah, macchiato.
Double or single?
Double.
Yeah.
Two, one for him as well.
Oh, you want another one as well?
Yeah. Excellent.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now for today's 2020 idea to better health, please welcome on stage Dr. Joe.
Welcome back. I'm Dr. Joe of the drjoe.com. If this is your first time on this channel, can I extend a warm welcome to you? This is your home of 2020 Ideas for Better Health. So if you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe. And also please don't forget to click on the notification bell because that's how you get notified of future videos that I make. So like I said before, today I want to talk about the effect of caffeine on our cardiovascular health and mental health as well. In particular, specifically, I want to talk about the effect of caffeine on the blood pressure as well as anxiety. The reason I want to do this video, I've done a similar video before, as you probably know, but that one was all about coffee. But I keep getting questions regarding the effect of caffeine on blood pressure, and I felt I needed to clarify this. So this video is about the how. I'm going to talk about the basic physiology and the decision as to whether you want to keep consuming as much caffeine as you like will be up to you. It's not going to be prescriptive, but it's just going to be descriptive. So the final decision is going to be yours. So what happens when you consume caffeine? First of all, let me have a sip. I don't normally drink a lot of coffee, but I've paid for this, so I've got to drink it. So what happens when I drink this coffee? Well, the coffee is going to get digested and the caffeine is going to get absorbed into my bloodstream. And when it gets to my brain, what does it do? Well, it blocks adenosine activity. So the caffeine blocks adenosine activity. Adenosine is a chemical in the brain that is supposed to signal to our body that we're tired. That initiates the rest activity cycle, so the rest part of it. So ideally we should rest to recharge our bodies. But when we consume caffeine, that activity is blocked, so we no longer feel tired, we no longer feel fatigued, and we get our buzz, we get that psychoactive kick. That's why caffeine is actually described as a psychoactive drug. So that's the effect in the brain. So what about our arteries? Well, we also have adenosine receptors in our arteries, and the same effect actually happens in our arteries. What does that mean? Well, the caffeine actually blocks the adenosine receptors in our arteries, and adenosine is supposed to be a vasodilator. A vasodilator is something that relaxes the blood vessels, but when that activity is blocked, what tends to happen is you have stiffening of the arteries, narrowing of the arteries, and that results in a rise in our blood pressure. So that's the first mechanism through which caffeine actually raises the blood pressure. So what else does caffeine do? Well, it goes to adrenal organs. The adrenal organs are tiny organs on top of our kidneys. It goes in there and it signals the release of adrenaline. And what's adrenaline? Let me just turn to Bradley. Bradley, oh, by the way, Bradley is my son. Wave to the camera.
Hello.
So adrenaline is a hormone, true or false?
True.
Excellent, he knows his stuff. So it goes to the adrenal organ, signals the release of adrenaline. And what's the major action of adrenaline, Brad?
I believe it prepares our body for fight or flight response.
Excellent. Well, money well spent. All the money I spent in his schooling him is money well spent. Well, he knows his stuff. He was paying attention in school. Yes, adrenaline actually prepares our body for fight or flight response. But the effect doesn't end there. It actually has an effect on our arteries as well. What does it do in our arteries? Well, it goes in there because we have adrenaline receptors in our blood vessels, in our arteries. And over there, what it does is that it actually causes narrowing of the blood vessels as well. So that's the second mechanism, because once they're narrow, what happens then? Our blood pressure goes up. But not just that, when you have adrenaline in your circulation, the next thing that happens is that It's not actually good for anxiety. So for somebody who has issues with anxiety, adrenaline makes you restless, it makes you nervous. So that's another reason why caffeine is not a nice product for you to consume if you got problems with anxiety. What's the next thing that caffeine does? Well, it actually revs up what they call the sympathetic nervous system. Now, if you've got high blood pressure or you've got anxiety, you don't want the sympathetic nervous system to dominate. You want the parasympathetic to dominate. You want that parasympathetic dominance. The reason for that is the sympathetic nervous system raises your blood pressure, it makes you nervous, it raises your heart rate, but the parasympathetic does the opposite. It brings your heart rate down, it lowers your blood pressure. So you want the parasympathetic dominance, but when you consume caffeine, what tends to happen is your blood pressure goes up as well. So that's another mechanism through which caffeine actually affects your blood pressure. And of course, it also makes anxiety worse because of the effect on the sympathetic nervous system. So what's the next thing that caffeine does to our body in terms of blood pressure and anxiety? The effect of caffeine on the adrenal glands is not limited to the release of adrenaline. It also actually stimulates the release of cortisol. Cortisol is a stress hormone. We need a bit of cortisol in our circulation, but you don't want a lot. So when you have an elevation of cortisol levels, that also leads to narrowing of the blood vessels, and that means your blood pressure is going to be elevated. And also, because cortisol is a stress hormone, it's also not good for anxiety. Now, is there another way that caffeine actually affects our blood pressure and anxiety as well? Well, the final thing is that, in actual fact, when you consume caffeine, this caffeine that I've taken this afternoon, how long does it take for my body to get rid of it? Well, the average half-life of caffeine in our system is about 6 hours. That's why my usual advice is that you should not be consuming caffeine beyond 2 p.m. The reason for that is it may have an effect on your sleep. In particular, the sleep quality, because there are 5 stages of sleep and it will affect the smooth transition from stages 1 to stage 5 of your sleep cycle. And if you don't sleep well, what happens? You're going to have difficulty controlling your blood pressure, and that's going to have a knock-on effect on your anxiety as well. So if you notice, I have a lot of videos on sleep, and that's because sleep is so important to the control of your blood pressure, and sleep is also very important to how you manage your anxiety. By the way, coffee is not the only food that has caffeine in it. There are other food products, other beverages, and here's just a list of some of those products.
So the effect of caffeine on blood pressure and anxiety is not actually a sustained effect. I just want to make that clear. The effect is actually temporary, but this varies from person to person. How temporary will depend on whether you are a fast metabolizer or a slow metabolizer. Of course, if you're a slow metabolizer, then the effect is going to last longer. The next thing I need to say is that caffeine effect on people with anxiety and high blood pressure is usually longer compared to individuals who do not have these medical problems. So here is a list of some of the products that are caffeinated that you may or may not be aware of. This list is not exhaustive, by the way. So here we go. Iced tea, green tea, oolong tea, black tea, matcha tea, yerba tea, morning dew, diet morning dew, kick citrus, mellow yellow, red flash, Red Bull, Bang energy drinks, Monster energy drinks, Jolt, Storm, Ruby Red, Mr. Peeb, Sunkissed orange, Big Red, Snapple flavored teas, Diet Coke, your regular Coke, Pepsi Cola, Pepsi Twist, Canada Dry Cola. To all intents and purposes, all cola drinks are actually caffeinated. Root beer, regardless of the brand, whether it's Mug, A&W or Barks. Sierra Mist, Sundrop Orange, A&W Cream Soda, chocolate flavored ice cream and frozen yogurt, coffee yogurt, Quaker Cocoa Blast, pudding. Over-the-counter medications like Excedrin and Midol, Kashi Granula Bars, Red brand of protein bars as well. They are all caffeinated. Like I said, this list is not exhaustive. Just to give you a flavor of some of the products. The thing to remember is that you may actually drink your coffee and still consume some of these products without realizing that they are caffeinated, but the effect actually adds up before you know it. So what should you do? What I would say is you listen to your body and how your blood pressure control is, how your anxiety control is. if you're struggling to get on top of your blood pressure management or your anxiety management, then you have a decision to make as to whether you want to limit or avoid consumption of some of these products. And of course, that includes coffee. Like I said, this presentation is just going to be descriptive, but not prescriptive. The decision as to whether you want to limit or avoid consumption is actually up to you.
So, by the way, if you enjoyed this video, as usual, give it a thumbs up. Please share the video as well with your friends, your family members, as well as your colleagues. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe. It's right there. I think that's all. If you've got any comments to make them right down there. That's it. Until next time, well, this is Dr. Joe signing out.
Yo.
So, what happens? I've just had this sip now. What happens next? Go pause in. Oh.